National championship game here at the Jack Simpson Gym. Our game this evening features the number 4 Windsor Lancers against the number 2 UBC Thunderbirds. Before introducing the teams, please welcome to center court Scott Edwards, Vice President of the CIS Women's Basketball Coaches Association and a women's basketball coach at the University of Alberta. Lindsay Drury, a fifth-year forward and recipient of the 2012 Sylvia Sweeney Award from Lakehead University. And Chelsea Drager, Manager of Community Partnerships for the Canadian Breast Cancer Foundation. The CIS Women's Basketball Coaches Association is donating a check for $98,706.92 to the Canadian Breast Cancer Foundation, thanks to the fifth edition of its annual Shoot for the Cure initiative. An additional $22,500 was amassed by schools that elected to donate their fundraised money to local or provincial organizations. The initiative was launched in 2007-2008 to raise awareness and money to fight the deadly disease, and in 5 years, CIS women's basketball programs have now collected over $500,000. This season, for the first time, all 43 universities that field women's hoops teams participated by holding one or numerous fundraising games or activities over the course of the campaign. Please give them a round of applause. Now let's introduce the teams. First, the starting lineup for the Lancers. At guard, a 5'8", fifth-year player from Calgary, Alberta, number 4, Emily Abbott. At guard, a 5'11", fourth-year player from Windsor, Ontario, number 5, Boyana Kovacevic. At center, a 6'5", fifth-year player all the way from Prague, Czech Republic, number 8, Eva Peklova. At guard, a 5'8", third-year player from Windsor, Ontario, number 10, Maya Marie Langlois. And at center, a 6'3", third-year player from Saint-Lambert, France, number 11, Jessica Clemenceau. The Lancers are coached by head coach Chantal Vallée and assistant coaches Tom Foster, Josh Lehman, Heather Angus, and Mike Gibala. And now the starting lineup for the UBC Thunderbirds. At guard, a 5'8", fourth-year player from North Vancouver, number 1, Kristen Hughes. At guard, a 5'10", second-year player from North Vancouver, number 6, Christiana Young. At post, a 6'2", fifth-year player from Halifax, Nova Scotia, number 12, Sarah Huntley. At forward, a 6'0", fifth-year player from North Vancouver, number 13, Alex Fewig. And at post, a 6'3", fourth-year player from Victoria, British Columbia, number 15, Lee Stansfield. The T-Birds are coached by head coach Deb Huband and assistant coaches Kerry Watts, Ramin Sadigiani, and Sean McGinnis. Tonight's game will be officiated by Troy Agar, Reed Scott, and Penny Wright. The Ryerson Athletics and CIS basketball communities are mourning the loss of Sandy Potier, who passed away on January 21st, 2012, after a courageous 2-year battle with cancer. She was 50. The former Ryerson Rams women's basketball coach is respected and remembered as a woman of influence, leader, coach, teacher, and friend. Potier coached the Rams for 18 seasons and is the longest-serving coach in team history. She mentored and coached over 220 student-athletes, including 32 OUA All-Stars and award winners at Ryerson. In her final year with the Rams in 2009-2010, Potier guided her squad to its best-ever regular season with a record of 14 wins and 8 losses. 4 of her players were also recognized with OUA awards and All-Star selections that same year, the most of any team in the OUA East Division. Potier achieved many wonderful milestones in her life. She worked as an apprentice coach for the Canadian national team and was an Olympian who worked as a scouting coach at the 2000 Sydney Olympics. As a player, Potier spent 2 years at Dalhousie University and 3 seasons at the University of Victoria, where she won a national championship in 1985. She also played and coached professionally in Germany, winning a Southern Bavarian championship. Please stand now and join us in observing a moment of silence for Sandy Potier. Please now remain standing and join Annie Patterson for the singing of our national anthem.
land. True patriot love in all our sons command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true north, strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
Said Jim Bronze, baby. We saw it on screen in the pregame. Such a cherished bauble, and boy, I know the Lancers don't want to surrender it, but the Birds would love to get it back. They won it three times over a five-year span, but trying to end a drought here that's lasted since 2008.
Yep. Yeah, let's take a look at those winners, and really, it's been dominated, not just by the Canada West, but by the Pacific Division.
Yeah, it certainly has. You look at that, and Windsor broke that 19-year drought, looking to extend that one more season. The Canada West hungry again to get it back.
Beklova to take the tip-off against Huntley, and the Windsor Lancers win it. On the right side, Kovacevic over the left side for Abbott, the native of Calgary, down low for Beklova, working against Huntley. Back up top for Langlois. Here's Langlois, inside pass for Abbott, reverse layup up and through for the first two.
Yeah, so aggressive early by Langlois, and that's what she has to do, work hard off the screen, Jim. She made the great cut down low.
Kristen Hughes up top. Right side viewing. Here's Huntley. 10 left on the shot. Huntley rambles in against Beklova and then coughs up the ball.
Well, that's tough.
Windsor ball.
Yeah, really. Zara tries to put the ball on the floor, coming out of her comfort zone to drive it into the paint there. Lost her footing down low.
Windsor in the navy and yellow.
Yeah, see the defensive matchups early too, Jim. Sorry to interrupt, but Chris Young is getting punished off those screens, as you just saw there. High screen off the top, Clement Saun is freeing Langlois to get to the basket two straight times.
Langlois with the two, UBC in the royal end goal. Going from a broadcast left to right, bodies go flying as UBC slows the ball down with Young. Nice pass inside, finish off neatly by Lee Stansfield.
I love the way Lee Stansfield is able to stand her ground. That's a good test inside to be able to establish post position, get that lob from Young. But let's watch the screen action here at the top too.
Langlois right side for Abbott. Up top for Beklova. Swings the pass in for Clement Saun, back for Beklova. Nice pass underneath.
Oh!
And it's blocked. And UBC recovers.
Yeah, Viewegg showing her defensive tenacity there, coming from the weak side to get that blocked, Jim, is a big play early in this game.
Viewegg right side for Hughes. Thought about shooting, then takes it back up top. And a whistle away from the ball.
Well, that is the battle down low, and we talked about Beklova only playing those 18 minutes yesterday. So, really key.
And there is that big block to set the tone by Alex Viewegg. Here's Stansfield. And the ball's knocked out of bounds. And Langlois will put it for Abbott. Back for last night's player of the game. There's Beklova. She's lost in legs. Stansfield recovers. And away comes Hughes. And another whistle away from the ball as things are getting physical away from the ball, away from the focus of play.
And we stopped talking about the physical stuff because, you know, UBC showed it could handle the physical play of Ottawa, but clearly Windsor realizes it has to up the physical ante here. We're seeing a bit of that here. And again, there's Pekova, Jim. We are just over 2 minutes into this game, and she's already taking a seat. Everybody, take a look at those matchups on the floor. Suddenly, UBC doesn't look that small, and the key matchups look to be, you know, pretty even all over the place here.
Laura Mullins checks into the game. She was 3 of 7 from three-point range last night, 11 points on the evening. She was deadly at key times from the perimeter.
You got that right, Jim. If she's a sub off the bench inside, that just shows the depth of your team.
Langlois underneath up top for Abbott. Abbott rambles into the paint, elevates, puts it off the heel of the iron, scramble for the rebound. Now and a whistle.
Well, we talked about getting that seal too, and protecting from UBC's perspective the ability for Windsor to go to the glass. And as Coach Harley said, you know, there's going to be a lot of missed shots in an intensely defensive game. Kristen used the seal to get the ball back for UBC.
The foul was against Kovacevic. It's her first. Ewing on the perimeter with a dozen seconds left on the shot clock. Faces. Puts it wide. Rebound claimed by the Birds as Huntley can't get it up in the double team. Puts it back for Ewing. Entry pass inside for Huntley. Makes the move. Oh. Puts it up short. Battle for it. Mullins comes down with it.
Well, Zara works so hard. Her work rate is great there for UBC. Unable to get it against Clemenceau.
Langlois up top. Wanting some movement. Here's Mullins. Left side for Abbott, working off the screen. Thought about the shot. Here's Mullins in three-point territory. Four left on the shot clock. Takes it to the top of the lane. Feeds underneath. Clemenceau can't bury it. And UBC will recover.
And you see two Birds under the post there to take away that offensive rebounding opportunity. They have looked at the box score, Jim. They know where they can't get hurt. And it's on the, they have to dominate on their defensive glass.
And Stansfield was dispossessed of the ball by Mullins, so it will be Windsor ball.
Well,
Lancers up 4-2.
Sorry to interrupt. Abbott's still on the floor here for Windsor. This is right around the time Carissa Williams usually comes into the game and makes a huge difference off the bench for this Windsor team.
Abbott in for Clemenceau. Picks it back outside, and Clemenceau is called on the travel.
You're noticing some jitters from Windsor, too. I mean, they had great execution in their first two plays, the high screen and roll there that got Langlois to the basket.
Well, you mentioned Williams, and she checks into the game for the Windsor Lancers, and away goes Emily Abbott back to the bench.
Well, here's what UBC has to do, Jim. They have to anticipate the change in play, the aggressive tempo that Williams will now bring into this game. Abbott more the three-point shooter. Williams is the driver, the slasher with the active hands on defense.
Same starting five out there for UBC. Here is Ewing. Oh, almost a steal there. But Young recovers, 4 seconds left on the shot. She'll take it inside, pop it off the window pane for the deuce.
Well, that's a great move by Young, and I mean 12.5, 9 rebounds a game, 6.5 assists. She's doing it all for UBC.
Williams, Mullins, entry in for Clemenceau, turns and faces, top of the key, no mistake for the native of Saint-Rambert, France.
Wow, there she is. I mean, she can do so many different things. If she starts knocking down the 15-foot jumper consistently today, really is going to cause, you know, to UBC to make some changes to how they defend her.
Hughes handing it off for Ewing. Crossover dribble, turns, elevates, and rattles the cage for two.
Well, teams making shots here early, fighting through the jitters of a championship game, Jim, a 6-6 game. Everything's being contested. Great movement on the floor, though, offensively.
Good pace so far in a tight game. Langlois. Kovacevic. 4-3, hits the triplet.
Well, she can shoot it. There's no question she did that yesterday, too. You look at that team, Jim. Everybody can shoot the three other than Clemenceau, who doesn't take threes. I mean, they can all spread the floor and shoot it, including the post Mullins.
Ewing on the perimeter up top for Huntley. Inside for Young, spins, and is called on the travel. Some good defense interface by Langlois,
yeah,
once again.
And Langlois, and we mentioned that right off the top, the marquee matchup right now. They have almost identical stat lines. They are slightly different players, but they have the same effect on their teams. Able to go into the post, defend in the post, knock down jump shots. They're real leaders from the backcourt to the frontcourt.
Spagnuolo checks into the game for the UBC Thunderbirds, taking out Young. There's Williams driving against the double team. whistled down at the edge of the lane.
And what a difference she makes to the whole tempo of this game. I mean, we talk about Emily Abbott in that starting group. She's on the bench now. Emily Abbott with two threes yesterday in the second half, Jim, and that's what she can give you. But Carissa Williams is a player that is a difference maker on the floor because they already have a lot of three-point shooters on the floor. She brings that ability to slash to the basket, and you look at how active she is. Every time she squares up to defend you, she thinks she's going to get a steal. That's a special player.
Foul was against Tori Spagnuolo. That's her first, the first one against UBC. And the shot is popped through from the charity strike by Williams. Lancers up by four.
So Windsor, you know, making things count here. They're getting to the basket and the jump shot by Clemenceau. UBC needs to start establishing stuff inside.
Huntley drives inside, hooks it around, and it swirls down the drain for two.
Yeah, you have to be courageous against Clemenceau. You can't expect her to just stand there and not do anything. So Zara extends herself, gets a great angle off the window.
Heinrose. Top of the key, pressured in there by Young, leaves it for Williams. Driving into the lane, kicks it back outside, three-point look, popped through for Kovacevic, her second three-pointer of the game.
Yeah, and it's Kovacevic today. Mullins has had her share knocking down the three ball, so varied in their attack, and they established that three early. That's really advantageous for Windsor.
Here's Young with a dozen seconds left on the shot clock, drives down low, and it's Clemenceau with the rebound.
Troutman
has partially deflected. UBC has the ball with Buick out for Young.
Those two guards, though, are so tough. Lang Lois and Williams, they make it so tough. Here's a tough shot, too.
By Spagnuolo. And it doesn't fall. Matches up 13-8 with 3:18 remaining in this first quarter. Another three ball heaved up by Kovacevic, and it doesn't fall that time.
And when they start relying on that and start settling for it, that's when UBC can start to make a run. You look at the minor officials table right now, Knievel set to come in, and she can shoot that three ball for UBC.
Nice entry inside there. There is a struggle underneath and a foul. That'll be against Mullins. It'll be her first.
So Mullins there coming on the double team strong, Jim, trying to get that jump ball situation or the steal. And yeah, just a little aggressive there because Zara was able to get that ball away from her at the last second. So good call there. Talk about Knievel subbing into this game too. She's going to inbound the ball here.
She is along the baseline, puts it into the hands of Young. Elevates from 13 feet. Racks up the two.
Right, Chris can shoot the jumper, obviously put it on the deck as well, but clutch shot there on the baseline.
Williams. In for Clemenceau. Two people in her neighborhood, puts the shoulder down, puts the shot up, gets her own rebound, and then gets blocked by Huntley.
Wow, that is tough too. Zara gets positioning. I mean, there's no question, you know, you're going to take your bumps guarding Jessica Clemenceau, but, you know, she gets right back up off the floor after getting knocked right on her rear end. And you know what? If she just stays straight, she's not going to get called, Jim. She gets up and she's like forward a bit, and there it is right there, trying to get too much of a block. Just be positional down low and you're not going to get that call. You hope.
Clemenceau at the line. 4 of 6 from the stripe in the semifinal. She's 1 of 1 so far tonight.
How can you not like what Windsor's done? They've come out. Clemenceau's hit that 15-foot jumper. She's making her mark physically in the paint, and they're scoring in half-court situations as well. They're getting what they want out of their offense each time down the floor.
There's Knievel over the timeline. Right side, Young. Thought about taking the baseline, takes it up top, kicks outside for Buick. Buick pulls up, jumper, yes!
Well, Alex Buick answering the call. UBC struggling in other areas on the floor, Jim. She's now knocked down back-to-back jumpers, one on the baseline, one in the paint.
Lows for Clemenceau, finds the handle on the ball, draws the triple team. The ball is knocked out of bounds. It will be Windsor ball with 13 seconds left on the shot.
And you see Zara Huntley out of the game now. Lee Stansfield taking a primary defensive role against Jessica Clemenceau, and a good job there, standing her up on the baseline.
Into the game now is LaRocque for Windsor. She leaves it for Clemenceau. Her jumper is short, rebound by Stansfield.
And I think Lee Stansfield has to dive right into that post area too. She can make things happen too. She's got a great amount of up fakes in the post.
Neville lost the handle, and now there will be some wholesale changes after a brief rest. Kovacevic checks back into the game for Windsor. Kristen Hughes into the game for UBC.
And certainly Huband expecting a battle here, giving Chris Young a rest early here.
Viewing right side to Neville. 10 seconds left on the shot. For Spagnol. Back for Knievel. Does she have many options here? Here's the crossover drive inside. Stripped of the ball. Goes out of bounds. And with 1 second left on the shot, UBC will have precious little time on this inbounds.
Well, just get it in and just get it at the rim. You just want to draw iron and go up there and try and get an offensive rebound in a situation like this.
And that's what you can do with about 1 second on the shot clock. Away come Windsor. Abbott, her three ball is short, comes off the iron, right into the hands of Williams, but as she got control of it, she bounced it along the baseline.
Well, Clemenson remains, you know, on the floor with this group, as does Mullins, but a smaller guard-oriented group here for the Windsor Lancers.
Hughes. Knievel. Screened in the form for it, kicks it back to Hughes.
Well, UBC needs ball movement here. They want to free themselves for a look at three. As you know, they have not had a good look at three in this game yet.
Stansfield feeds inside for Spagnuolo. She was marked closely. Ball knocked out of bounds. The UBC ball to inbound with three left on the shot.
Yeah, Tori Spangel is getting a lot of early touches of the ball, Jim, in this game. And you know what? She is that second chance generator. You should see her go off the offensive glass. She loves to contest the ball. So you'll see her dive down.
And that shot wouldn't have counted anyway if it would have dropped.
So a one possession game, Jim, and you know what, UBC's had their dips. Windsor, you know, has really exerted themselves, but UBC has found ways to score. I would say their 12 points, very resourceful in how they've gotten them to fall here. Zara Huntley with a couple of baskets there, you know, in tough post matchups, and really Alex Vuig stepping up as a jump shooter in medium range territory.
Langlois. Kovacevic, Mullins, back inside for Clemenson, finds it and pops it home for two.
Yeah, Lee Stansfield lost her defensive positioning there, and Clemenson able to squeeze it and go right to the basket. As easy a hoop as she's going to get in this game.
Well, 15 seconds left on the shot.
This is very similar to the perimeter front they showed Calgary early in the game yesterday in their national semifinal. Where is the entry? Look at how much they're having to struggle.
Duig elevates. That shot is well short of the mark.
And 5 seconds on the shot clock, too, and they're just hoisting the shot up at the end, Jim. They're not getting any quality looks.
Kovacevic, yes! The third three-pointer of this quarter for Koyana Kovacevic. She is 3 of 4 from three-point range, and she, at least her outside shooting, has been the difference in this first quarter. And it is the end of the first as the Lancers lead the T-Birds by 8. You're watching the Bronze Baby.
21-12 after 10 minutes of play. Lancers lead the UBC Thunderbirds here in the Women's National Basketball Championship.
And Bojana Kovacevic has been deadly from the perimeter.
She has, and you look at the fact that they exhausted the shot clock and made UBC hoist up a bad shot, then come right down to end the quarter with that big three. That was huge.
And Young pops it through for two as a reply for UBC to open up this second quarter.
And that's the one thing they don't want is Chris Young to get on a roll. She's now 3 of 4 from the field. Quality looks and really playing with authority on the floor right now. Jim is their offensive leader.
Langlois, she is rejected inside by Stansfield.
And big for UBC too, because they've got to try and take away the interior, the inside, the baseline, the speed of those two guards, Williams and Langlois, on the baseline has been very effective for Windsor early in this game.
Langlois to inbound, and then a whistle. She took too long.
Well, good front by UBC there to crowd her, take away her options over 5 seconds, and give the ball back to Kristen Hughes.
No surprise here, Kovacevic is the leading scorer so far with 9 points. One player with 4 viewing for UBC. Young now with 6 points on the evening. Underneath, wow. Off the glass and in for two, Zara Huntley.
Well, that's a big move there inside by Huntley. She's got her share of points. She did sit a bit in that first quarter. They've kept her fresh. She does have one foul, but she's gonna try and match up against the most physical post matchup in this game, it looks like, every time down the floor, Jim.
Yeah, that pass across the key for Clemenson. It's knocked out of bounds.
And the response, Tessa Krieger into the game at 6'4" for the Lancers. Obviously, Piklova with those two early fouls. They feel they have to keep size in this game, Jim.
And it's popped through in for two by Abbott.
Emily Abbott. She can shoot the ball, as we saw yesterday. Do not leave her open, as she showed you there.
There's Krieger working on defense against Stansfield. Stansfield's shot does not drop. Away come the Lancers.
Well, setting it up here and seeing what they can do. Krieger has not really played a lot in meaningful minutes in this tournament. See how she handles the minutes here in the half-court set, trying to set a screen on Hughes.
Langlois elevates it, pops home the triple.
Even without that physical screen, she is there to really shadow out the moon. She's very big, 6'4".
Young replies with a two back, but at some point in time, UBC's got to get their perimeter shooting just a claw back into this one as they are down by 7.
And they're going to have to make some stops too in the half-court set. Windsor very inventive. They're not just relying on one player here to score.
A little bit of a miscue there, but Langlois recovers out on the wing, drives inside and glides, but does not drop. Rebound underneath,
wow.
And it is claimed and swung through by the freshman Tessa Krieger.
And you see the big smile on Chantel Valley's face, the whole bench cheering. They bring in the Seldonese sub at 6'4", Jim, and she's winning battles down low. That's key for them early in this game.
There's Knievel, lost the handle. Hughes feeds inside, and Huntley gets popped on the way to the glass.
Well, that's what your response has to be. You know, it's mano a mano, and that's a great move there inside by Zara. She's got to keep the physical play going.
And that will send UBC to the line.
Yeah, this game at one of those kinds of danger points, when you start to get up to the double-digit area, if you don't have a response, you know, especially from the physicality standpoint, you know, you tend to shrink and you tend to give up a big run and in a championship game, I don't know. So Zara, as a senior, stepping up there, absorbing the punishment, making 1 of 2.
13 of 18 from the line now for Huntley. There's Williams taking the pass, getting bumped in there, and it is finished off to extend the Lancer lead to 10.
And this is a timeout UBC has to take right now, Jim. They have to talk things over. They do not have the same level of urgency at all 5 positions on the floor. And you see that when you pursue loose balls the length of the court. Follow your...
As the governing body for university sport in Canada, CIS welcomes you to today's event. We're celebrating CIS's 50th anniversary, so be sure to check out CIS-SIC.ca for more on the 50th anniversary. And let's kick it over to the band of Outriders.
Yes,
pass over the timeline. Right side, Williams up top for Peklova, who just checked into the game, worked down for Langlois. Right side, Williams. Will she venture inside with 8 seconds left on the shot clock? Kicked outside for Peklova. Along the baseline, she rumbles. Pops it in, but it will not count as she is called on a travel.
There will be the turnover there, and they had a turnover as well, or rather a made basket in the exact same situation. You see the reverse layup opportunity by Peklova. Kent does not going to count with the travel. Same way Tessa Krieger scored a couple possessions ago, Jim.
Hughes on the perimeter, and a whistle and a push away from the ball, I believe. This foul's going against Peklova.
Yeah, she just can't cope with the physical play down low. If that is the case, her third foul of the game, and Mullins will come in.
Peklova with good size, well, great size, really, but elusive speed at times. She can anticipate the game well, but that's just a little too physical underneath against Huntley.
Yeah, we've been talking about that as they show us. Thanks to the guys up in the truck there for that replay, because Huntley is winning that battle with Peklova down low, no question.
Young takes it to the rack, but it doesn't work out for the Thunderbirds. Away come the Lancers.
Well, 10-point deficit. This is where you need to show defensive hunger in the half-court set. Take away their options, no lanes to the basket.
There's Williams underneath. Her shot is short. Some good defensive pressure, and we're going to have a jump ball.
And that ball then will stay with the Lancers on the alternating possession. But you saw more urgency there, Jim. And just more communication, accountability in the half court, not giving open lanes to the basket, and really contesting everything.
7 seconds left on the shot clock for Kovacevic to work with. Inbounds. It was a little wide for Williams, recovered by the T-Birds.
And that's how you build momentum. Each step, get your stop, come down, try to get a good quality look at a made basket.
Ewing, left side for Young. Young will drive into the paint. She'll put it up too strong. Mullins comes down with the rebound.
Yeah, you're right about the English there. You can't blame Chris, though. She's ventured in twice in this quarter and scored both times.
There's Clemenceau in her office. Puts it up. That one is just off the iron.
She's tough to guard. She's got so much movement in her game with her back to the basket. Zara takes a big pop in the face and falls down, but gets back up.
Spagno leaves it for Young.
Yeah, Chris running the point here and really trying to recognize what's there. Wants to take the jump shot.
Young off the elbow, and it goes off the heel of the iron. Away come the Lancers once again. There's Williams. Talk for Langlois. Inside for Clemenceau, and when she gets that step towards the glass, she's going to pump it in every time.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, there's guard skills in her game, and that's what makes her so imposing when she gets a space on the baseline like that.
Here's a long one from Kristen Hughes for the triple.
We got it from a UBC perspective. She was the fire starter yesterday, Jim. We remember in the second half against Ottawa, back-to-back threes that really gave UBC separation, this time pulling them to within 9.
First big three-pointer for Hughes, but here's the response the other way. Does not drop for Kovacevic. She's now 5 of 3 from three-point range.
Yeah, and the key there for her on the miss, though, is aggressively following her miss, Jim. Drawing the foul, Tori Spangel. Tori Spangel gets called for the foul there.
And for Spangel, that is her second personal foul.
Chantal Vallée bringing Tessa Krieger back into the game now.
UBC 4 of 8 from three-point range, as you saw against Ottawa. That was one of the difference makers, as they shut down the GGs in the second half. Only 7 points for the GGs offense fourth quarter.
You'll notice Clemenceau not on the floor. Big proving time here for Krieger as the post, the go-to post inside in the set.
As Krieger trying to provide the screen for Langlois. Underneath, it's popped in.
Wow, Chris Young took a huge pop in the face there. I think she's checking for blood. The official talking to her as well. Those guards, Jim, have a level of grit that is off the charts. And we're talking about Carissa Williams and Maya Marie Langlois. They are so tough.
Number 10, Maya Marie Langlois with the bucket for the Lancers. And the Thunderbirds call timeout.
To learn more about a career with CSIS, go to Intelligence.
Le service canadien du renseignement de sécurité est à l'avant-garde de la sécurité nationale. Pour plus d'infos sur une carrière au SCRS, visitez intelligencequiconte.ca.
Terminus! Let's hear from the Band of Outriders.
I mean, this is the point. This is where UBC has to answer before the half, Jim. They're down by 11 with 4 minutes left. They need to show that they're still battling and in this game.
Gunn swings it right side for Hughes. There's the entry underneath. Hewitt can't make it work. And away come the Navy in goal.
Yeah, that was a tough opportunity. Zara had great position down low. Zara Huntley just could not get the ball to fall.
That's it. They work it around, stops with Langlois. Up top for Krieger. She'll let a long one go. That one rattles off the cage, but Williams is there to mop it up once again.
Yeah, we talked about those six or seven offensive rebounds she had yesterday. She is everywhere around the ball.
A whole lot of Windsor Windex, as we referred to before. But that one doesn't fall for Williams.
Yeah, we'll see if they go right back into the post. Zara wants the ball. She's demanding it in the low post right now. Now coming to set the screen.
Parkin, who just checked into the game for the first time, right side for Young. Young directing traffic up top for Stansfield. 5 seconds left on the shot clock. No one open underneath. We're going to have to heave this one up before the 24-second clock goes, and that's a clock violation against the T-Birds.
The 3:04 left here to the half. They've come out of a timeout. They know what their marching orders are, but they still had no recognition of the shot clock there. And I know Chris Young really, you know, getting frustrated there. Slapping hands with Kristen Hughes as they get ready, but Deb Huban said at communication, they've got to get into their sets and they have to be way more decisive.
This is actually a pretty important possession here for Windsor as they could start sharpening the first nail in the coffin.
Yeah.
If they can find some points here.
Well, Stansfield gets a hand on it, but hard to keep him from shooting that three ball.
Kovacevic underneath, she gets clipped and fouled. And she'll go to the line.
See, and that's how you determine, you know, why a team's winning a basketball game. Because they're hustling to get an offensive rebound. They don't really get that offensive rebound, but they draw a foul and get to the free throw line. Right now, the hustle factor there is just there for them. And it's just contagious through the whole lineup, Jim.
The UA second team all-star. This is on her first. Didn't get tested at the line all that much. She's a deadly three-point shooter, but was not successful on both attempts from the strike.
Well, break for UBC here. But as Carissa Williams is not going to give up, she's pressuring three-quarter court by herself and getting a hand on the ball.
There's Hughes over center.
So UBC not going down in the post now. They're spreading the floor, trying to set a high screen.
Williams pestering Young. Young gets it back and then feeds inside, and the foul called on Mullins as there was a battle for it between her and Huntley.
Yeah, 10 on the shot clock though, and there's a recognition there that as they inbound this ball, they've got to be decisive with what they do. Not a whole lot of time to set up in the half court.
Second foul against Mullins. Three team fouls against Windsor and two against the T-Birds.
Now, Tessa Krieger now back in for Mullins. One good play and she's holding her ground, getting a chance to really show what she can do in the championship game.
Williams clips that inbounds pass, and here's Langlois to the cage and in for two.
And there you go, off a simple inbounds, Jim. Fingertips matter in this game, as we've said. All of that coming off a tip, off an inbounds play and hustle.
Now this is going to Hoyle so far for the Windsor Lancers. This is their game plan, their pressure defense, getting in lanes, being disruptive, creating
gritty,
opportunities.
Gritty and having an attitude counts for a whole lot, and they're showing that to here in the first half.
Ewing. 9 seconds left on the shot. There's that pestering defense provided once again by Williams. But here comes Young. 2 seconds left on the shot clock, and it skims over the cylinder. Wow.
We talked about how hard Calgary had to work. They had to keep working and working and working, and they finally broke through and able to get to within double digits. Jim, that's the level of work that UBC has to put in here.
Long pass for Viewig, fall away, doesn't drop, and Williams gets the rebound.
Yeah, that, clearly Calgary set a tone for what you have to do, and UBC has to play to that same level of energy. Great play by Viewig.
Williams gets it, and we'll bring it back over the line. 6 seconds left on the shot clock. Clemenson kicks it out for Abbott. There's Clemenson with a long-distance shot. That's not her comfort zone.
Well, if they hit a shot there after pursuing it 80 feet down floor, that would have been pretty deflating.
There's a long pass, and it is converted by Ariane Parkin.
Yeah, Adrian Parkin, the rookie. Good job by her, able to get down the floor. And that's what you do when you run the floor and work hard. You're never going to be slapped on the wrist for working hard in this game. It pays off for Parkin.
Gap of 11. Clemenson leaves it for Krieger. Krieger has it popped out of her hands. And away goes Viewig. And she finishes it off with the two.
Well, she's been an energy player with 30 seconds left in this half, Jim. She is trying to captain what's happening. 50-year player wants to go out with a title in her last season.
Brings the gap down to single digits with that steal and the deuce. Gap of 9. 9 seconds left on the shot clock and 12 left in the game clock. The baseline jumper rattles away for Langlois. This will be the last shot as Parkin's shot was partially deflected by Abbott. And the Windsor Lancers look every bit the defending national champions they are, as they really controlled that second quarter to take a 9-point lead into the dressing room, Howard.
They set the tone as they head to their...
First up, the Cal West Mini A gold medal and provincial champions after a 29-0 season. We're joined first by the team's coaches, who are lining up on the court, and will welcome their teams as they parade into the gym. So up first, the Cal West Mini A gold medal and provincial champions, who had a 29-0 season. And now the Cal West Mini A gold medal champions, also provincial champions. They had a 29-0 season. The players are Paige, Kennedy, Hillary, Lucia, Ceci, Jenna, Emily, Alexandra, Jordan, and Natalie. And they're coached by Corey Blaskin, Dan Adams, and Andy Lappin, and team manager Elaine Duby. Our next team we're honoring here at halftime, the Cal West Bantam A gold medal champions, also provincial champions, also with a 29-0 record. The players are Victoria, Taylor, Jordan, Lauren, Hannah, Manyo, Kennedy, Renee, Rosen, Daniela, and Jillian. And they're coached by Carrie Blaskin, Rob Godfrey, and the team manager, Valerie Coulomb. Our next team, the Cal West Midget A Gold Medal Champions. They're made up of Sarah, Madison, Morgan, Amy, Emma, Chelsea, Andy, Kirsten, other Kirsten, Ciara, Julia, and Megan. And they're coached by Elaine Baumhoff, David Madsen, Jerry Gilwich, and team manager Barb Johnson. Our next team, the 2 Tina 1 Juvenile Girls Gold Medal City Champs. They are Nina, Letitia, Lainey, Alexa Jade, Sadie, Kaylee, Megan, Kieran, Daisy, and Tiffany. They're coached by Stanley Big Bloom. The next team we're honoring here at halftime, the Edgemont Varsity Juvenile Girls Silver Medal winners. They are Alex, Madel, Christine, Christina, Milana, Carolyn, Emily, Jennifer, Angelina, May, and Christina. They're coached by Ari Vanderkill, Coach Andrew McClellan, and Ryan Bang. Our next team up is the Nose Creek Mini Girls, silver medalists and city bronze, silver medalists at cities and bronze medalists at provincials. They are Carolyn, Julia, Yvonne, Jillian, Rihanna, Rianne, Bailey, Danica, Ashley, Emmy, Serena, and Abby. And they're coached by Shauna Beckley Mason. Our next team is Selfish Creek Bantam A, city silver medalists and provincial silver medalists. And they are Rachel, Malia, Lisa, Carly, Megan, Danielle, Lander, Shannon, Beryl, and Natasha. Coached by Clark Grew, Rob Morgan, Victor Kai, and team manager Cheryl Grew. And last but not least, the Varsity Edgemont Midget A City Silver Medalists. Number 4, Claire. Number 7, Maria. Number 9, Jill. Number 15, Erica. Number 31, Maddie. Number 35, Marnie. Number 33, Carly. Number 41, Molly. Number 55, Sophia. And number 6, Kendall. They're coached by Bill Garner, Colin Feasby, and Dan Amy. Let's give it up to all of our successful girls basketball teams from the greater Calgary area this season. Who knows, maybe they'll be here at the CIS Final 8 someday. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. We'd like to thank the Calgary Minor Basketball Association for all their support this weekend at the CIS 2012 Women's Basketball Final 8. Thanks you coaches and players for joining us here. And congratulations once again to all of Calgary's female basketball superstars. And now let's hear some more musical stylings from the band of Outriders. We'll be right back. With over 38 years of experience, Centaur Products is Canada's leader in sport contracting. Specializing in sport surfacing for indoor gymnasiums, running tracks, and athletic fields, Centaur Products is a proud supporter of CIS Sports. Thanos Athletics would like to thank the following sponsors for their contribution to the 2012 Women's Basketball Final Eight. Stuart Olson Dominion Constructions Limited, RTS Services Incorporated, The West in Calgary, Charles Glenn Toyota Scion, and the University of Calgary Bookstore. Thank you. Ranger Inspection, the presenting sponsor of the 2012 CIS Final Eight and a proud partner of Thanos Athletics. The Windsor Lancers lead the UBC Thunderbirds here after 20 minutes of play in the CIS Women's Basketball National Championship. Leading the way offensively for the Lancers is number 5, Bojana Kovacevic. She had a trio of triples in the first quarter. And it's good for a game-high 11 points. For UBC, it was number 6, Chris Young. She has 8 points, not far behind number 13, Alex Buig, had 6 points.
And a half million.
UBC to start the ball. Second half.
Now it's time for the second half as the UBC Thunderbirds have a bit of a hill to climb, down by 9 against the defending national champion Windsor Lancers, Howie.
Yeah, fifth-year players like Huntley, like Viewegg, the two captains on this team, had to step up at halftime, send a message that this is the half, ladies. It's a time to answer the bell. And if you want that bronze baby, it's going to come over the next 20 minutes.
UBC Thunderbirds shooting 41.4%. The Windsor numbers dropped off a little bit as well, down to 45.2%. But the big number that stands out here for me, Howard, rebounds. 22 for Windsor, 13 for the UBC Thunderbirds. And the big person on the glass, that Windsor Windex, as we like to say, on the offensive side, Bojana Kovacevic, with 3 rebounds. She also nailed 3 three-pointers.
Yeah, I know. All her rebounds are offensive boards. She leads her team with that three-point shot. She was so varied. That is a skill set that if you can get those kind of special things happening in the game, good things happen for your team, Jim.
Laura Mullins takes her third personal foul. That means she will cool her heels as Peklova checks into the game.
Well, the emergence of Krieger in 6 minutes of play with 2 points and 3 boards, Jim, big, because the Windsor posts, with all the good things they're doing, are struggling to keep away from fouls in the paint.
Huntley splits the D and pops it home for 2.
Yeah, and that's the senior leadership. Zara Huntley knows she has to be a go-to girl down there, so 2 aggressive moves on the first 2 possessions by UBC, that one resulting in the field goal.
Peklova inside for Clemenson, back for Peklova. She puts a long one up. It skims over the iron, and the rebound claimed by Huntley.
Well, some transition down the floor quickly here for UBC. Chris will attack the basket, and we haven't seen a lot of that happen in this game.
And Young draws the foul from Emily Abbott.
So, 3 possessions, Jim. See the UBC bench standing. They have to, as you see Chris driving to the basket, establish things that are going to get them easier buckets down the floor. And getting that rebound into transition, drawing the foul, big for the Birds here in this early part of the third quarter.
For Abbott, that's her first, but she goes back to the bench, and coming into the game for Windsor is Carissa Williams.
And that's hardly a drop-off in terms of your subs.
Well, it was a 9-point gap at the start of this third quarter, all of a sudden we're looking at a more manageable five-point gap for the UBC Thunderbirds.
And how hungry are you defensively? That's the question UBC answers here.
Windsor in possession. There is Clemenceau making the move.
Well, they get long in the paint. They have to do that. Clemenceau with a big drop step move, but the length of UBC inside prevents that basket from falling.
Clemenceau or Peklova. 15 left on the shot. Left side, Kovacevic for three, her fourth triple of the evening.
And she hits it right in front of the 6-1 Buig, who gets right down the floor.
And there is Buig, who draws the foul.
But the look on Alex's face when Kovacevic drops that three on her is like, hey, I guarded her, man. She's just hitting a tough shot. And here it comes.
And a nice open look. Wow. And when you're in the groove, you are in the groove.
Yeah, you're in the groove. And really, they challenge it, and Alex takes that. Buig takes that personally. She gets right down the floor, Jim, and gets the contact. So UBC really holding true to what they need to do. They've given up the big shot to Kovacevic, which she's done all through that opening half of play. You know what? Maybe they give her the threes, they take everything else away, but you can't let her just keep knocking down threes if you're also going to give up shots in the paint.
Langlois swings it wide for Kovacevic, and the return pass for Langlois underneath.
That is called a hard cut to the basket, and that is called communication on the floor.
Buig, cross court for Young, up top for Hughes for three. That one off the lip of the iron, mad scramble for the ball. Buig comes down with it and converts for the deuce.
She is hungry to get her team back, Jim, and they've made a nice run here. This is a two-possession game, and we were a 13-point deficit in the first half, so UBC clearly has a fire lit, and they're playing a lot more emotionally.
Clemenceau for Peklova. Peklova swings it in off the leg of Clemenceau, and UBC comes away with it. Young on the run right side for Buig. Buig will slow things down, angle it outside for Huntley, thought about the baseline, then marches it into the paint, makes a move around Peklova, and converts it for another two.
And she will consistently win that matchup, especially when she's facing up to the basket, putting the ball on the floor, and using that length to go around Peklova to the rim.
Four-point game in favor of the Windsor Lancers. Langlois. Will the screen for him, finds some room, swings it right side. Clemenceau, rebound comes out. Young tries to wrap her hands around it. It's knocked out of bounds. It will be the UBC Thunderbird ball.
Well, that is Jessica Clemenceau's ball to knock down, because that is such an explosive penetration move in the paint. Real unselfish kickback to the big shooter on the baseline.
Here is Hughes, left side for Young. Long pass into the corner for Buick. She'll put it up and it'll rattle off the cage. And away comes Williams.
Well, transition defense is huge. She can't hold that pivot foot there, Jim. Just over half court. Carissa wanting it all, pulling up at the last second.
And Williams called on the travel, and it is time for a timeout to perhaps stop a bit of the bleeding here, Howie.
Well, UBC came out with a purpose, Jim, and that's what it's all about at both ends of the floor.
The official apparel supplier of Canadian Interuniversity Sport, Russell Athletic, welcomes you to today's event. Be sure to check out yourrussellgear.ca to order customizable CIS Russell Athletic merchandise. Let's hear from the band of Outriders.
Guard talent and interior talent. UBC has a big climb here, even though it's only 4 points.
Kovacevic, by the way, with 14 points so far this evening. UBC in possession. Huntley puts it up top for viewing. Dribbles into the side of the lane and is called on the travel.
And there is Kovacevic. They're standing tall on the baseline. She creates a very difficult target to wrap that ball around, and the turnover does give the ball back to Windsor.
Langlois Silver center. Wins it up top for Peklova. Down low for Kovacevic. Back for Peklova. Baseline jumper, long distance, off the lip of the iron and out. And away come the Birds.
Yeah, Stansfield on the weak side with a big rebound to get them down the floor.
Looking to make this a one bucket game. Do they go for three? No, there's the entry inside for Stansfield, who takes it to the hole, drops it through, draws the foul. She will go to the line and try to make this a 1 point ball game.
We will take a look at that. This is old school drop step basketball on the playground. How do you play in the low post? Lee Stansfield might not be the most recognized player in the nation, but she took one of the best players in the nation, you know, right to the rack there. She has so many fundamentally sound low post moves. You just got to get her the ball in open space, one-on-one, and she wraps up the end one opportunity.
UBC now 6 of 7 from the line, and if this game shifts to the charity stripe, that might be a place where UBC can try to decide it. They have clawed back from a 9-point deficit to begin this third quarter to make it a 1-point game. Bodies fly all over the place, and there's a push.
Yeah. And see, you know, this thing is, you have to throw yourself into the physicality, and you have to just put your body on the line, and Alex Viewegg clearly is willing to do that as a fifth-year player on this team. Of course, 2008, as we see it here, Jim, there you go.
Kovacevic with her second personal foul. UBC with an opportunity to pull into the lead on this possession.
Yeah, there's the lob inside, and great play. You know, Peklova's had the foul trouble, Jim, but she's come in really focused the last two or three possessions at both ends of the floor.
Yeah, we mentioned that about her speed a little earlier in this game. She knows how to read the lanes. There's the jumper that clangs out of the cage for Langlois.
UBC would love to run. I know Coach Taylor talking about those low scores, but if UBC can defensive rebound and get some easy baskets in this game, they would be very helpful, thankful, because everything has been contested by Windsor. It's been tough, tough blue-collar basketball.
Young to inbounds for UBC with 18 left on the shot clock. Floats it down into the post for Huntley. Puts it up too strong, and Windsor will come out with it.
Yeah, she was expecting the block to come from Peklova, put a bit too much on that shot.
Right side, Williams up top for Mullen, who's carrying three fouls. Here's Mullins. Left side, hangs off for Langlois. Backs off with 8 seconds left on the shot clock. The screen doesn't form. Time running out here. Long distance three put up. It's an air ball. Mullins underneath can't get it back up again. And an uncharacteristic air ball put up by Kovacevic.
Well, Mullins is in the fray there, and she's going to get to the free throw line. I mean, that is a tough break for UBC. I mean, you defend the entire shot clock, Jim. You get them to hoist something, and because it's an air ball and she's underneath the basket and she's a tough, gritty player, she just gives it everything she got to get possession to get fouled.
Foul is against Huntley. That's her second. Mullins makes her first at the line. She's a 90% shot from the stripe. And you can see perfection there for the Tracy McLeod Award winner. That award given out for perseverance. Talk about perseverance, she's had three different surgeries on her knee.
There's UBC trying to skip that ball inside. They love to play to Zara, you know, moving without the ball, going to the basket. Zara's face-up skills, very, very imposing if they can do that. And Kristen Hughes looking for that skip pass inside, just could not get the ball through to Zara.
There it is off the foot. Changes on the court for Windsor. We will update you on. Clemenson is back onto the court. Here's a three ball put up. That's off the side of the hoop. UBC recovers. Here is Young. Cross court left side for Hughes. Thought about the three. Backs off. Double team is attracted to her. She swings it in for Young. Drives down low. Puts it up and gets a friendly bounce and in. And it's a 1 point ball game once again.
That is a pack mentality defense on the baseline. But I'll tell you, Kristen Hughes was not sure what to do. Chris Young, way more decisive when she got that ball. Battling with three guards on the baseline, Jim, and making a tough, tough shot in traffic.
12 points for Chris Young so far this evening for the Thunderbirds. Lancers up by one. And come on, Saul.
Wow.
Falls to the court in the double team, and UBC will absorb another foul.
Well, you got to look at that on the replay. Zara gets there. She's completely there defensively. I mean, she is set completely there. Clemenson simply turns into her, and Windsor's going to get the call there. I mean, it happens.
Even with a bit of a low shoulder there, too, that is not very fortunate for the T-Birds. So Huntley will come out of the game.
Zara has got to watch that foul count. So valuable what happens here, but you know what? Windsor is such an aggressive, physical team. They will just keep coming at you.
Here's Abbott driving down low and pops it high off the glass and in for a deuce.
Yeah, great move by Emily Abbott there. We talk about her three-point shot, Jim, but you know what? The lane there, take it.
And Williams and Young get into a bit of a dance and a foul.
And this game got to a one-point game when Stansfield completes that N1 play. But Windsor doesn't back down. And we talk about Carissa Williams. You see, look at those hands, Jim. Active on defense. She has not met an offensive player that she's going to square up against where she's not going to try and steal that ball.
Second foul for Williams. And the 13th point for Young. She'll try to make it 14 here and turn it back into a one-point ball game.
Well, there's a lot of perseverance here for the UBC. They have shown us something here in the second half. But they've got to do it right now without Zara Huntley on the floor.
Williams driving down low, kicks it outside. Open look, Abbott, rebound. UBC gets the handle on it. Back though, up for Hughes.
Well, they get their three looks so easy because they can penetrate and kick out from the baseline with their guard play so efficiently.
Shot is short by towards Bagnell. Bagnell's coast to coast, drops it home, draws the foul. She will go to the line, the player of the game from last night.
Well, you watch Langlois, you know what, gets right to the basket. You know, we saw the end of it, Jim, but the start of it is what's important. She goes the entire length of the court, and nobody stops her until she gets to the rim. And by that time, Kristen Hughes is having to chase her. Really, really determined play to get down the floor, but UBC's transition defense has to be there.
And Langlois completes the three-point play. Lancers back up 47-43.
And here's a rookie running the point against the most dominant player on the floor right now in Cassandra Knievel, number two for UBC.
Bagnell, left side for Young. She backs off with 7 seconds left on the shot, working against Abbott, trying to find some room, swings it right side for Knievel. She elevates and puts it off the lip of the iron. And it will be knocked out of bounds, and it will be Windsor, Lancer basketball.
Yeah, the Lancers really, really are trying to find a second win here, Jim, after UBC makes that big climb to get back into this game. And it looks like they're the ones starting to find some mojo here on the floor.
Yeah, whistle away from the ball.
Well, check that, because UBC.
And the foul is against Spangle. It's her third personal foul. A little bit of a block underneath there. My number three of UBC.
Yeah, Tori Spangle there trying to stay on the floor and do her best defensively.
Clemenson kicks it outside for Langlois, back inside for Clemenson, swings it over for Peklova in the double team. Good work by Stansfield.
It really is, Jim, because Spangle's having to guard Clemenson in the post, and it's not easy. And so weak side help there by Lee Stansfield, huge to get them back down the floor.
Knievel, Young. Green closes, but a nice return pass underneath for Stansfield.
And haven't seen the defensive breakdowns in the half court a lot today by Windsor, but clearly there, UBC gets what they're looking for, a wide open look into the paint.
Lancers by two. Here's a long distance shot put up by Peklova. It doesn't drop. And Young sweeps in on the loose ball. She'll bring it out of the backcourt.
Well, a chance to tie the game here, and Chris Young has made such an offensive dent in this game, leading the charge here.
Hewitt gets the handle back on it. And then that's partially deflected by Kovacevic. Loose ball, Abbott picks it up, and UBC loses the opportunity to tie or go ahead. Here's Peklova, puts it up and through from close range.
She shakes her head and she comes out the court. She wasn't anticipating getting that ball. She had to make a quick decision down there.
And some collateral damage away from the play, and Abbott will draw the foul. That'll be the second personal against Calgary's Emily Abbott.
Yeah, and you see Peklova there using the left hand off that quick dish for the basket, making it a four-point game. It's just UBC getting so close, but this Windsor team has so many qualities that you have to continually knock them down if you want to try and, you know, make that run that gives you the lead, as we watch Hewitt make that first free throw. Jim, they do so many things well.
UBC now in the bonus. Four team fouls against UBC, five against the Lancers. And the second shot doesn't drop. Who will get the loose ball? Kovacevic. And this is it for Langros.
Yeah, this guard group so effective. Kovacevic joining them as the big three shooter today. Ooh, and neat Stansfield. You know what? That's what happens. You know, Huntley goes to the bench, and they are going to start to look to Clements on every time down the floor, Jim. And they're testing the UBC post. They've had Spangel guarding Clements on, Stansfield guarding her.
Well, that was the question of one of the headlines that we asked at the start of this broadcast. How big is big? And in that case, when you're matching Stansfield up against Clemenson, she's big in more ways than one. Yeah. When she goes into that post.
Well, the key there is getting Jessica the ball in the paint where she can react in a one-on-one matchup. And that's what they're getting right now as they're going through their half-court looks here. Like the last play, just isolating Clemenson with Stansfield and making a big aggressive move.
The BLG Female Athlete of the Year in Canada last year makes both from the stripe. Lancers up 51-46 with 41 seconds remaining in this third quarter at the Bronze Baby. Entry pass broken up neatly by the Lancers.
Yeah, the depth not there right now. UBC is hurting in the post trying to get the offensive looks they want. Spangel just couldn't get that entry pass inside.
Kovacevic for Mullins. Nice entry inside for Clemenson. Muscles her way in, follows up on the rebound, falls to the court, and the Thunderbirds will control. No, it will be called a jump ball. And on possession, wow, will go to Windsor.
But it's weird because UBC got the ball, and I think Alex Vueg thought a foul was being called on the Windsor player there. It's because she almost relaxes with it. And she's like, are you kidding me? It's a jump ball?
Well, that time there's a foul, and that may be a costly foul for Windsor. If it's against Mullins, this would be her fourth.
Wow, and that really does affect what they can do in the post.
Indeed, it's against Laura Mullins, her fourth.
So Mullins' fourth really forces Windsor to react, and they will bring Peklova. Well, they thought about it. They're not going to now. They're going to bring in...
They're going to go with Krieger. They're going to go with the freshman. A different type of size. Krieger at 6'4".
And Spangel, who's shooting these free throws, has had to step up in a huge way defensively. And you know what? She is learning how to play in the post on the highest stage of the country right now. And getting some free throw chips here for her determined play defensively at the other end of the floor.
Roy Spangel from White Rock, part of a provincial championship team with Elgin Park.
You remember that team, Carly Graham with Regina, Jess Franz with Calgary. It was a talented group.
12 seconds remaining. One last shot for Windsor in this third quarter, up 51-47. Langlois going to create some space. 2 seconds remaining. Turn, shoots, it's short. And the Windsor Lancers will lead by four. Good work by the UBC Thunderbirds to eat into that 9-point lead. You're watching the Bronze Baby on Shaw and NBA TV.
Riders.
Fifth edition of the annual Shoot for the Cure initiative. 98,000 specifically by the CIS and a number of other contributors topped at over $120,000. By the way, University of Waterloo Athletics Department raised $25,000 of that. So a tip of the hat to them in a very, very worthy cause.
Well, I know we're here at the game, Jim, and this is important, but it was great to see all the pink this year at the CIS games and the support being shown for a great cause. And I think very fitting here on our final basketball day of the year in the CIS that such good news is able to be spread.
51-47, Windsor leading, looking to add to it as they try to zero in on back-to-back CIS championships. Williams drives to the hole and pounds it through for two.
Yeah, I just love the acceleration of her dribble and the confidence that she has all over the floor with her handle, and that's how she gets to the rack so frequently and with such authority, Jim.
Hughes right side for Knievel. There's a triple hop and a triple team. They find some relief, and there's the entry inside for Huntley. Does she walk? No, she manages to maintain the tightrope and find the deuce.
Yeah, great work for Zara because she gets her own offensive board and sticks with the plan. She plays through the contact, Jim. So key if you're determined for a Zara Huntley.
Langlois for three, and we have seen that on three occasions where UBC gets close, gets the two, and Windsor responds with a triple.
Yeah, big triple there by Langlois for sure.
Right side, Buig.
Well, UBC wants to go inside out, Jim, but they're being defended so closely. They're having to manufacture space on the floor, and that is the hardest thing to do.
Nice rebound by Knievel, feeds underneath, and Huntley converts it.
Well, well-earned assist from the rookie Cassandra Knievel from the 9-0, Jim. Love that skip on the baseline, recognizing her senior post right there under the basket.
Five-point gap. Lancers in control. Here's Peklova up top. Right side for Langlois. She backs off with 10 left on the shot clock. Right side, Clemenceau over for Peklova. Her shot is short. Rebound handled easily by Huntley.
Well, they do create some space with movement on the baseline there, but Peklova is not a jump shooter, Jim. Not the highest percentage play to give up the ball to her in the paint.
Hughes calls the play with 10 left on the shot. Knievel comes free, left side. Got momentarily about the three. Gets a partial screen. Try to swing it across the paint. Stansfield recovers. Puts a wild shot up right at the 24-second buzzer. And there was some wrestling underneath.
Arms locked there. Peklova and Hunt.
And that foul was against Huntley.
Wow.
And that will be her fourth, and she is on the tightrope.
That is a huge foul right now for UBC, Huntley's fourth. And you saw how they were struggling in the post, Jim. When she was sitting, she's gonna have to go back out trailing by five. There's still plenty of time left in this game. But you attack what you can if you're Windsor, and clearly they have marching orders. You'll see them go right into the post here.
Langlos, right side. Kovacevic. Kovacevic driving top of the lane, up top for Abbott. Right side for Krieger. Puts it up and charge underneath.
Well, Tessa trying to set herself on the baseline. And you know what? She's got the size. Sometimes it's hard to play with that size, as you'll see here. Doesn't have to exert herself like that. She just needs to set herself and not play out of control like that on the baseline.
Second foul for Tessa Krieger.
But you know, she's going to touch the ball a bit here. Well, actually, check that. Clemenson now back in the game, Jim. So clearly the Twin Tower effect still in place here for Windsor.
Long distance three by Hughes. That one well off the mark. Krieger with the rebound. Windsor quickly come back. Langlois left side. Kovacevic. Entry to the side of the lane for Clemenceau. Clemenceau backing in against Stansfield, and she has her way, she has her pair.
And what can you do? They're knocking down the three like crazy. You can only commit one to single team defender. That is tough.
Gap of seven. Spangel walked. It will be UBC ball with 15 left on the shot.
Talked about UBC and the real lack of a three-point game. One of six in this game through three quarters. Just can't get the looks. It's not like they can't hit them, they just can't get the looks.
No one has been able to get outside looks against this Windsor team at this Bronze Baby tournament. UBC is no exception to the rule so far.
Yeah,
hot pass deflected out of bounds, Windsor ball.
Need to squeeze that. Torrey tried to catch that bullet pass, couldn't do it. Now it's right back to the chore if you're UBC. Boy, that is a quick rotation of post players from Chantal Vallee. Peklova just sat, now she's back, and Tessa Krieger back, so.
And so is Huntley for UBC with four fouls with 6 minutes remaining.
Wow.
Come on, song. Working against Stansfield. Stansfield stands tall. Knocks it down and sends the ball the other way.
And UBC would love to get a quick hit. Look, they just can't get him in this game here, so they'll carve it up in the a turnover there, though, on the wing, Jim.
Yeah, Hughes tried to swing it around Langlois. Langlois would have none of it, and then Hughes is called on the block.
Boy, that whole adage of having great defenders on the floor and what they can do in terms of just, you know, creating and putting your imprint on the game can't be more true. And you see why Maya-Marie Langlois was the MVP of last year's championship win over Saskatchewan for these Windsor
Lions. ...is at the leading edge of our country's national security. To learn more about a career with CSIS, go to Intelligence...
Le service canadien du renseignement de sécurité est à l'avant-garde de la sécurité nationale. Pour plus d'infos sur une carrière au SCRS, visitez intelligencequiconte.ca.
If Dwayne Washington is here, please come see the scorers table. Dwayne Washington. Please, in the scorer's table.
Yeah, battle early with Peklova there, as we see. And clearly, you know what, you're 6'3", you can't hide. They're good at game plan for you. Zara's an intense competitor. She's had an incredible five-year career with the Birds. Of course, winning a CIS title in her first season as a rookie. But boy, there's that fourth foul, Jim. Locking arms with Peklova in the paint, real tough one.
Take a look at the results from other games at this Bronze Baby tournament. The bronze medal game, it was the Ottawa GGs, 79-73 over the surprise hometown Calgary Dinos. And in the battle of the rectangular province, it was the Regina Cougars over the Saskatchewan Huskies, 64-60 in the fifth, sixth place game, Howie.
Yeah, and those both close games, entertaining contests here, and a great day of basketball. You know, all those programs, they just come back strong next year. Give CIS basketball such great competition from coast to coast.
And a foul away from the ball. It's a push against Peklova. That will be her fourth, so she is on that foul tightrope as well.
Well, here's a look at it. Look at the bodies collapsing as they go inside, and all of a sudden you hear that whistle away from the play. This is a game that UBC can take, but how can they start to peck away at a defense that's been so effective from start to finish? It's going to take a special effort here to get a run going if UBC wants the bronze baby.
Right side for Young. Young drives from top of the paint, elevates, puts it off the heel of the iron, recovers her own rebound, off the glass, too strong, battle for the ball, Langlois away with it.
And you know that as this clock ticks down, Windsor's going to start taking its time, start looking for the good opportunities.
And they'll also just slow the ball down. There's Mullins, entry inside for Clemenceau. Finds the handle, leads it for Abbott, top of the key, jumper, no mistake for Emily Abbott. She has 8 points on the evening. Leading scorer, Langlois with 17, Kovacevic with 14, Clemenceau with...
With over 38 years of experience, Centaur Products is Canada's leader in sport contracting, specializing in sport servicing for indoor gymnasiums, running tracks, and athletic fields. Centaur Products is a proud supporter of CIS Sports. Let's hear from the band of Outriders.
CIS game with 50 points in a single game.
She won't talk about it, though. She's very humble.
UBC in possession. There's the entry in for Stansfield. Tries to scoop it towards the glass, and a foul underneath as Stansfield got the hook on Laura Mullins.
Yeah, and you can see the emotion in Lee's face as she comes back up the floor.
That'll be her second. Three team fouls against the Birds, two against the Lancers this quarter.
You hear Deb Huban, you know, diagramming those stagger screens, everything, Jim, but as she's wiping off that board, hey, girls, get some stops, too. That's what they have to do here.
Holding entry inside, and it's converted by Clemenceau from Mullins.
Yeah, and the size right now is working in Windsor's favor, and the fact that Huntley has those four fouls.
Ewig outside. Tried to drift it inside for Young. The door was closed by Williams. Langlois comes away with it. Right side for Abbott. They're going to slow it down with 4 minutes left on the clock. Mullins inside for Clemenceau. Back for Mullins again. Scoops it to the hoop. Drops it down. Draws the foul. And she will go to the line.
And this is going to match the biggest lead of the game, Jim, at 13 points. We had this in the first half. We're now in the stretch drive, though, and the game being influenced by fouls and the ability of players to play at their best is severely compromised right now for UBC with the foul situation. So this is imposing as Mullen hits that free throw.
Mullins with 5 points on the evening. She had 11 last night. Driving inside as Young goes off the heel of the iron. She follows up and follows through. 16 points for Young. Long pass for Williams, mishandled, and it will be UBC ball.
Well, they were able to get something productive with Young that time. But there was a point that UBC had to react, and it was about 3 minutes ago, and it did not happen, Jim. And boy, you know, they have a mountain here. It's going to have to take some very big shot making and big stops to even get close here.
UBC 1 of 7 from 3-point range. Will they go for it here? No driving inside as Hughes copied up the ball. Kovacevic just checked back into the game for Williams. She has the ball. Hands it off for Lanois. Back for Kovacevic. No Patty Cake with it. And a foul.
And that's happened a lot here today. You know what? Windsor comes down. They want to run their half-court stuff, but they show that great patience, and they're so active within the half-court set. They're drawing so many fouls away from the ball, running the shot clock down. There, the shot clock down almost to 10 before that foul happened.
That is only the first foul against Young. Zara Huntley carrying four for UBC. Laura Mullins carrying four for the Lancers. Those are the two with big foul trouble, one away.
And Huntley's had some tough breaks with her calls. That's what I would say today.
Hughes up top for Huntley. Left side viewing, working off the screen. All out of that shooting. Puts it right side. Long distance three is an air ball from Hughes. And it'll be Windsor ball, and the air is coming out of the UBC Thunderbird balloon right about now.
It is the biggest lead of the game, and we're under 3 minutes, but there's going to be no quit in the attack of this Windsor team.
Kovacevic inside for Clemenceau. Clemenceau backing in, kicks it outside, open look, Kovacevic! Off the lip of the iron, right into the hands of Stansfield. She relays it quickly up for Buick. Buick on the run, halts it up, pass inside, and leaning inside is Huntley. She can't make it happen. Draws the foul.
But that's what Zara Huntley can do with the entry passes. They just weren't able to get things going to the point where she was dominating and able to get the quick, easy touches on the block.
That wins the ball. There's Mullins up top. Nicely inside for Clemenceau, marches through, and she draws the foul from Stansfield.
And Clemenceau is so active, able to move athletically. And I think really, Jim, when you look at what's happened in this game, the ability of Bojana Kovacevic in that first half to establish that outside shooting game really dictated the fact that UBC couldn't double down when they wanted to. They had to pay respect to the perimeter, and it really allowed the paint game to take over when it needed to.
Ranger Inspection, the presenting sponsor of the 2012 CIS Final Eight and a proud partner of Dinos Athletics.
When you have the best three-point shooters and the top. And let her operate with more space underneath.
Clemenceau buries her first. She has 15 tonight. Make it sweet 16 for Jessica Clemenceau. Right side Buick has the ball chopped out of her. And Mullins ends up with it. Great effort by Kovacevic there with the tomahawk shot.
You're on the floor leading by 16 to save a ball off your own steal.
Windsor happy at the half court now with 150 remaining. Outside for Abbott. He flashes, then drives inside. Nice rejection there by Young.
And Chris Young has played her heart out. This UBC team has played, you know, Jim, they have played a good game. It's just that Windsor just is just on a mission at so many different points on the floor here. including right here.
Off the elbow, that's an air ball for Langlois. But Windsor has a great combination, don't they? They've got great chemistry, but they've also got all the right parts in all the right places.
Yeah, a well-balanced team with the ability to handle the ball and shoot it from the guard spots. Size inside, but most of all, I would say a mental toughness and a tenacity to want to just roll you over.
Windsor Lancers closing in on back-to-back championships. As the double team meets right in the middle on Clemenceau.
He's going to get called for steps.
So it will be UBC ball.
I'll tell you something, Jim, they're inbounding the ball here. UBC won their last three national championships all as the number two seed. They were the number two seed again. Sometimes the magic wears out.
Langlois. We're inside the final minute in this Bronze Baby tournament. Swung underneath, reverse layup does not fall for Kovacevic. And the Thunderbirds will hurry it out of the backcourt. Stops with Hughes. Right side up at the top for Young. Now it's marking her. There's Viewing inside for Huntley. Huntley loses the handle. Clemenceau emerges victorious out of that battle. And Windsor will walk it up with 25 seconds remaining, 20 on the shot clock. And the Windsor Lancers starting to get excited, starting to celebrate. Their fans are giving them a standing O here at the Jack in Calgary. What a homecoming for Calgary's Emily Abbott, fifth-year player. She gets to celebrate, and the clock runs out, 4.8 seconds remaining, so you don't want to light all those candles on the cake just quite yet. UBC will inbound. And the long distance three won't matter. The Windsor Lancers, back-to-back bronze baby champions in the CIS. Dominant all through this bronze baby tournament.
Well, they built to this, gym, and they came into this place determined that they weren't going to give up the bronze baby, and they will hold it, keep it, they will coddle it, and well-deserved against a very talented UBC team. So many great performances. How do you sift through how many great performances they had?
UBC, there's some tears over on that side, but you know what? Nothing to cry about. I don't think a lot of people expected them to go and play against Regina and come out with a Canada West Championship the way they did. They were solid in this tournament, but you know what? At the end of the day, the team with all the pieces and the team with all the pieces that worked together so, so well are deserving back-to-back national champions.
Yeah, they certainly are, Jim, and you know what? You start with Kovacevic and the way she was able to knock down the threes early. The toughness of Laura Mullins, you see there hugging with the baseball cap on, to come back from those knee injuries, to persevere, to want to do this for her team. Jessica Clemenceau, a marked target on her back every time she touches the ball, Jim, able to deliver. And then, of course, Langlois with her incredible defense and her ability to bring toughness on the offensive side as well. All the ingredients there, the depth to make a championship team. And on the other side, you look at the UBC Thunderbirds, and a real tough one for them too, because two seniors who won the national championship in 2008 as rookies on this floor. There you see Zara Huntley wiping away the tears, number 12. One of those players, Alex Viewing, also the other player. They won't be able to go out with the Cinderella story that they wanted so bad. So that's what it's all about, Jim. Competition down to the end, and the Lancers deserving victors here.
MVP for this Bronze Baby tournament, Mia Marie Langlois of the Windsor Lancers. Oyana Kovacevic of Windsor on the All-Star team. Chris Young of UBC on the All-Star team. Jenna Gilbert, who was outstanding for Ottawa, also on the All-Star team. And Jenna Kay, who was a one-woman wrecking crew.
Yeah.
Managed to make the All-Star team very, very deserving.
Yeah, good for Jenna Kay in her hometown to win that. And the UBC fans are waving to the UBC players, rather, as they leave the court. And Jim, always tough to lose, but what a victory for the Windsor Lancers here.
Now here, Ben Matchett, the assistant athletic director of the University of Calgary, as they get ready to hand out the best name trophy, the best name championship in all of Canada, the Bronze Baby. Serving back-to-back champions, the Windsor Lancers. Some people would say there was an asterisk from winning it on home court last year. This was convincing, a couple of time zones away from home, as Windsor will claim the pennant and claim the Bronze Baby. And of course, the traditional team picture. Number four, you see Emily Abbott, lone Western Canadian on this team. Gets to celebrate at home.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to recognize the championship all-star team and most valuable player from the 2012 CIS Women's Basketball Final Eight. We invite Doug and Lois Mitchell to come forward and present the awards. The tournament all-star team from the hometown University of Calgary Dinos, number five, Jenna Kay. There she comes. Also a tournament all-star. From the University of Ottawa, Gigi's Jenna Gilbert. From the UBC Thunderbirds, Christiana Young. From the University of Windsor Lancers, Bojana Kovacevic. And the most valuable player of the 2012 CIS Women's Basketball Final Eight, for the second year in a row, from the Windsor Lancers, Maya Marie Langlois. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for your 2012 Women's Basketball CIS Championship All-Star Team. Maya Marie Langlois, Bojana Kovacevic, Christiana Young, Jenna Gilbert, and Jenna Kay. Now we'll present the silver medals to the 2012 CIS runners-up. Let's hear it for the University of British Columbia Thunderbirds. Please welcome Dr. Drew Marshall, Provost and Vice President Academic of the University of Calgary, and Ron Wattila, Director of Athletics at the University of Calgary, to present the silver medals. And please come forward as I call your name. Number one, Kristen Hughes. Number two, Cassandra Knievel. Number three, Tori Spangle. Number four, Chloe St. Amour. Number six, Christiana Young. Number seven, Stephanie Bell. Number eight, Alyssa Binns. Number nine, Adrian Parkin. Number 10, Erica Viewing. Number 11, Zanna Williams. Number 12, Zara Huntley. Number 13, Alexandra Viewing. Number 15, Lee Stansfield. And the head coach of the Thunderbirds, Deb Huband. And the rest of the coaching staff, ladies and gentlemen, your 2012 CIS silver medalist, the UBC Thunderbirds. Now, to present the gold medals to the 2012 National Champion Windsor Lancers, please welcome, from Ranger Inspection, the presenting sponsor of the 2012 CIS Final Eight, Alex and Jolie Romano. Please come forward to accept your gold medals. Number four, Emily Abbott. Number five, Boyana Kovacevic. Number six, Carissa Williams. Number eight, Eva Peklova. Number 10, Maya Marie Langlois. Number 11, Jessica Clemenceau. Number 12, Jocelyn LaRocque. Number 13, Bethany Wachna. Number 14, Tessa Krieger. Number 15, Jessica Gordon. Number 21, Anna Mullins. Number 22, Laura Mullins. Head coach Chantal Vallée and the rest of the 2012 CIS champion, University of Windsor Lancers. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for your attendance here tonight. Congratulations to the national champion, University of Windsor Lancers. And we'll see you all next year at the 2013 CIS Women's Basketball Final Eight at the University of Regina.
And now one more time for the road, the Band of Outriders.
We'll be right back. Find out what is a holy bell. After midnight, we gonna let it all hang and suspicion, give an exhibition, find out what it is on laid back. After midnight, we're gonna let it all.